Hi, I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week we are going to look at five rackets that are really near and dear, very close to my heart. And these are five great control and feel rackets. So if you're really looking for that plush, loaded with control and feel response from a racket, these five are great options to take out there on the court. First up, we are going to start with an absolute classic, and this is the Wilson ProStaff 6085. This was Pete Sampras's racket. Roger Federer used this racket. Stefan Edberg, Roger Federer's coach, used this racket. Ton of great names associated with this one. It's got a ton of Grand Slams behind it in its history, and it's still viable today. If you like to serve and volley, or if you just love that feel and control, really look to manipulate the ball around the court, get it to targets with a lot of mass coming in behind it, this is a great racket to do it with. Only has an 85 square inch head size, but the thing I like about it, it's got so much mass and plow through the ball that it just crushes that impact. It really wins the impact war with the ball, and it just plows through, and you can hit a really, really big shot with this one. So much so that I actually string this up quite a bit tighter than most of the other frames we're gonna look at, just because the weight of this one really does push the ball with good depth. I prefer it over the 90 square inch Wilsons, the Tour 90s, etc. And it just comes through a little quicker. Smaller head makes it really snap through. It's a great racket for one-handed backhand, topspin or slice. And then also on the serve, it's really gonna zip through the contact because it's a nice small head, so you can really whip it through, very aerodynamic. Much more modern racket, but still tapping into that classic feel, is this Super G10 mid 330 from Volkl. And this one is just, again, loaded with feel. It's got a thicker beam than the ProStaff we just looked at, but it's not super stiff. It's got a nice solid, sort of a medium to low flex on it. Again, a ton of feel from this one. It's a fairly generous playing head size, I think. And you know, it's a mid, but it's right on the cusp there at about 96 square inches on this one. And I love it. We play tested this one. I really enjoyed that racket right there. Nice bright cosmetic on it too. Now here we have the Babolat Pure Control 95. This is a Tennis Warehouse exclusive here in the US. And this, again, it's a really nice, thin, straight beamed player's racket. All of these rackets, a headlight. These two just over 12 ounces. This one coming in around 12, or just a shade over or a shade under, depending what type of string you're gonna put in it. It's got an 1820 string pattern, so it's the densest string pattern we've looked at so far, and that is gonna give you a lot of control and a lot of feel as the ball impacts the string bed. You can string this one really low to really get a super soft and plush response, and yet you still get dynamite control out of the 1820 string bed and that thin, flexible beam. This is a really, really nice player's racket, and I think it's got a bit of room there to add some weight, to play around with the weight and balance if you like to do that. It's not too hefty, so plenty of room there if you want to customize that one just a little bit. Nice racket there from Babolat. Next up, I have a Yonex racket, and Yonex have made some really, really cool, really nice playing mids in the past, and I think this V-Core Tour F93 fits right in there. The isometric head shape you get on a Yonex always makes their mids play, I think, more like a 95 than a 93. It really does have a very generous sweet spot in it. This one has a really interesting string pattern too. It's very dense like the Babolat we looked at, but this one is a 16-21, so 16 mains, 21 crosses. It's a very unique string pattern. It works exceptionally well in this racket. Great blend of power, of control and feel, and there's just enough pop in this one to help you get the ball away. I really like the crisp, very dialed in response to this racket at net. Really felt like I could punch a volley deep and keep the accuracy spot on, and then when I wanted to hit a touch shot, ton of feel and a really crisp, very direct response there when I hit that little angled volley. And then one of the softest feeling rackets in the Prince lineup right now is this Prince Techstream Tour 95. It's got a very low RA, it flexes around 60 RA, but because of the use of their Techstream, Prince can get away with that really super soft and flexible feel, yet you still get good stability and some decent power as well to help you get the job done out there on the court. And this one, it comes around very quickly. It's nice and light and easy to get around for a player's racket. Good headlight balance on it. Love the feel and control at net. I do like to get a little bit more power out of this one, so string it very low. String around 48, £50 max. If I'm using a poly, I might go up to 52. If I'm using a hybrid or a multi-filament in this one, but I do like to string it nice and low, and you can get away with stringing it low because it's got so much control and feel, and that'll just add a little bit more pop back into the frame of this one. But this is a dynamite racket. Our play testers absolutely love this one when we play tested it, and Carly actually made the switch to this racket right there. It's got a great feel to it. All right, that's all I got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.